Things ain't so lucky. They've been left to freeze, or starve, or face the kid. Kids ready for the windbags this time. Well, windbags young and old keep fighting for the fort. Kid can't hardly tell up from down after a while. At least the marshals left the kid a parting gift. Something that'll punch clean through their greasy hides. Windbags ain't much different from normal folks. All they want's a warm place to stay and a decent meal. Calamity drove the windbags topside. A lot of them wound up here in this very fort. Could have been minding their business underground like in the old days. Thank you. Cinder brick gave him enough heat and metal to munch on for a while. Well, the fort ain't theirs by right. Can't blame them for wanting it, though. So many of those sorry things hold up inside that old fort. Blasting everything in sight with that newfangled musket. Put the kid on notice. Security's plane gone haywire. Windbags gummed up the works. kid ain't afraid of getting burned. Trap the kid in the middle of the fort's parade grounds. Then they bring out Glutus and Glandon and all their scumbag uncles. They got something to gain, and only their sorry hides to lose. Takes down Glutus. Or maybe it was Glandon. The other big fella soon joins his brother, wherever they are now. The windbags finally get the message. Kid used to dream of getting a marshal's badge, but not like this. And now ain't nothing left for nobody down at Cinderbrick Fort. Kid shows up.